Hey everybody, Mike Miller with the Herald Times, columnist Jeremy Price. Indiana headed up to East Lansing on Sunday afternoon, 1 o'clock against the number 8 Spartans. Another big game for Indiana coming off an emotional, important must-win victory over Iowa on Thursday night. Indiana back in the Big Ten title conversation in a three-way tie with Iowa, with Maryland. It's getting interesting, Jeremy.
Yeah, and this is the big backloaded part of the Hoosier schedule that we knew was coming, starting with Iowa, now going to Michigan State. You've got Purdue coming up, you've got a trip to Iowa coming up, you've got Maryland at the end of the season, so it's no surprise that Coach Tom Crean was so looking forward to this trip.
We earned this one, and we're proud of our guys, and it only gets easier. Now we get to go to East Lansing, so there's our schedule. That computer had a way of spitting out the schedule for us this year, but I know Tom has been sitting there anxiously awaiting this game, especially after Tuesday night, and they'll have 15,000 of his closest friends ready to go along with his team, and it'll be a tremendous atmosphere. But this is a big step for us tonight, and we're looking forward to our next challenge on Sunday.
Well, Coach Crean was obviously being a bit sarcastic, but there's no joke about this trip up to East Lansing. Always a tough place to play for anyone in the Big Ten, especially Indiana. But Indiana has some momentum now. Indiana's coming off that Penn State game with a very important win against Iowa. This, I think, Jeremy, can perhaps propel Indiana really into the teeth of their schedule moving forward over these next couple weeks.
I think this gives Indiana the confidence and momentum they need at this point in the season, where coming off that win over Iowa. Now they go into a situation where there's not a lot expected going on the road to East Lansing. If they can come out of there with a win, great. If they don't, it's really not a surprise. There's still a lot of opportunities ahead of them, but this would be a huge win if Indiana could back up the Iowa victory.
Beyond the opponents right now on the schedule, it feels like this is really the time of the year when you have to be mindful of minutes, of freshness, both mental and physical. What's sort of the task ahead for Indiana, I guess, measuring those minutes, the freshness for guys like Thomas Bryant, some of the freshmen? You're really getting into that second week of February. You're about to hit that wall, especially for freshmen. How can Indiana be mindful of those things headed into Michigan State and beyond?
Well, I think Indiana's definitely going to be aware of that. Maybe a little bit of a blessing in disguise, though, in the fact that because of the foul trouble that Thomas Bryant was in against Iowa and against Penn State, for that matter, he's relatively fresh as those things go coming off those two games. His minutes were limited. So I think that helps both freshman OG Anunoby and Juwan Morgan have played limited minutes. So again, those guys should be in good shape as far as their legs are concerned. You do that combined with the fact that in this situation, you're going on the road. You kind of let the hostile crowd maybe create a little bit of that energy for you, and you look at it as a no-lose situation. And given that, I think Indiana can be in as good a situation as possible headed to East Lansing under the circumstances.
Against the number 8 team in the country, this is both an opportunity to continue building on the NCAA tournament resume while continuing to establish themselves atop the Big Ten standings. We'll be up there 1 o'clock Sunday afternoon. You can catch us on Twitter, Mike Miller HT, at JP Price. We'll see you up there.